As previously discussed in my video on mineralogy, alchemy, and the occult, the Philosopher's Stone was reported to have been hidden in America by Johannes Kepler in Philadelphia in the early 1700s. This inspired migrants to leave to America who sought religious freedom from persecution. Kepler had been a hermit who lived in a cave among other disciples, most of which would die of tuberculosis from the conditions inside the cave. They belonged to a secret society called the Woman of the Wilderness. Among their alchemical knowledge, this religious sect also possessed the first telescope in America, which would come into the possession of Benjamin Franklin and British astronomer William Herschel. Herschel discovered the infrared light spectrum, and this is where the story of alchemy and freedom from religious persecution by the royal theocratic ruling class comes into play. The most renowned alchemist in history of British monarchs would be John Dee and Edward Kelly. John Dee was famous for using scrying stones in order to communicate with otherworldly entities. Likewise, Edward Kelly is famous for his collaboration with John Dee and their alchemical pursuits. After several experiments of scrying and attempting seances to commune with these entities of light, Edward Kelly is said to have discovered the language of an antediluvian civilization, which he called the Language of Enoch. The Book of Enoch is a Kabbalistic pre-flood story, otherwise antediluvian, which tells of the Watchers and the original pre-Adamite civilization. It is of vital importance to Gnostics and Masons alike, who most likely interpreted these findings in correlation to Norse mythology and French Freemasonry, with the Watcher god Heimdall serving as the key towards this interpretation. In Norse myth, it is widely known that Odin was hung from the world tree, the Yggdrasil, which interprets as death's gallows in Old Norse. So, in order to acquire the knowledge of the runes after 9 days, correlating to the 9 worlds of the cosmic world tree, Odin sacrificed himself. Despite this, it was not Odin that gave this knowledge to mankind, but the god Heimdall, who was born from 9 mothers. In the first stanzas of the Prose Eddas, it is stated that mankind are the sons of Heimdall, similar to the alchemical experiments with these entities of light. Heimdall is said to be the god of perception, who guards the Bifrost Rainbow Bridge, otherwise depicted as an archway within Masonic symbolism. For more information, watch my video on the Vigvasir, the alchemical Icelandic compass. Likewise, the Baron Karl von Reichenbach would describe these forces as Odic Force, named after the Norse god Odin. Gustav Fechner, the father of psychophysics, studied a branch of psychology that deals with the relationships between physical stimuli and mental phenomena. Similar to Edward Kelly, Gustav Fechner did experiments with lights and sun gazing, and Fechner became temporarily blind before regaining his vision and encountering these similarly described entities of light. For more information, I would view my video on the origin of sun gazing and how these so-called pseudo-scientific and potentially dangerous practices influence modern science, while their origins date back to early Judeo-Christianity and antediluvian times. There are several links to Norse mythology and Gnostic teachings which manifest through alchemy and the Kabbalah. For instance, the Norse fire god, Surtr, wields a flaming sword, which is synonymous with the Old Testament and the archangel Uriel. who was tasked as likewise a watcher over the Nephilim. I would recommend my video on the occult trinity for more information. Alchemy comes up in pop culture with the works of H.P. Lovecraft and the Necronomicon, written by the mad Arab Abdul al-Hazrad. Traditionally, the Arab world were the main proponents during the Golden Age of alchemy. The word alchemy itself is of Greek and Arabic origin. The so-called pseudo-fictitious Necronomicon describes the same text used by John Dee and Edward Kelly. In a modern sense, these bizarre alchemical practices most closely resemble that of Karl Polk Runyon, who founded the Temple of Astarte, an offshoot of the Ordo Templis Orientis, which utilizes psychomantiums and mirrors for scrying. The Temple of Astarte is again a reference to the divine feminine and Gnosticism, in reference to the Pleroma of Gnosis, or Sophia, which in Greek, Sophia means wisdom. For more information on this, I would recommend my video on the divine feminine. But that is all for now, and do, as always, check the links in the description.